Oscar De La Hoya is one of the greatest boxers of all time, not only in terms of what he could do in the ring and his accomplishments as an athlete, but also because of what he was able to make on the business end of the world of boxing. Known widely as a former professional boxer, Oscar De La Hoya eventually became a boxing promoter with his Golden Boy Boxing Promotions. And in 2018, Oscar De La Hoya became a mixed martial arts promoter as he diversified his business and went on to expand the different combat sports. Yes, Oscar De La Hoya is an accomplished businessman and promoter, but let us not forget what he did in the boxing ring, especially with his professional record of 39 wins against only 6 losses his entire career. And thanks to his early start in the profession of boxing, he won a gold medal in the Olympics back in 1992 in Barcelona, Spain. That is why Oscar De La Hoya was nicknamed the Golden Boy. True to his Golden Boy nickname, Oscar De La Hoya turned anything he touched with his boxing gloves to gold as he went on to become the top earner in pay-per-view revenues with a total of over $700 million. He has since been surpassed by Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao, who both went on to defeat him in the boxing ring during the latter portion of his career. In a boxing career that spanned 16 years, Oscar De La Hoya earned over $500 million in total revenue in his fights alone. Combined with his business acumen, De La Hoya has a total net worth of $200 million, which is a massive number thanks in part to his earnings as a boxer and as an entrepreneur and promoter. With that kind of money under his figurative belt, Oscar De La Hoya is a loaded man whose punching power is only surpassed by the power of his bank account. So, how does Oscar De La Hoya spend all that money? Well, that's what we're here to find out as we look at how Oscar De La Hoya spends his millions. Houses. There has always been something about professional athletes and huge multi-million dollar mansions that we just can't fathom. It seems as if these houses were made to be bought by these millionaire athletes. Well, we can't blame them, because they have the money and they will buy such houses and invest in real estate. Of course, they also need some place to stay and rest right after a hard day of training. That was what Oscar De La Hoya did with his money, as he spent a lot of them purchasing huge houses. Even though Oscar De La Hoya was far from being a heavyweight in the boxing ring, he once owned a mansion that now has a heavyweight asking price of $18.5 million. The story was that the fresh-faced boxer back in 1997 purchased the home for a value of $3.35 million when he was at the peak of his career and was ranked the top boxer in the entire world. He has since renovated the home, as it only increased in value more and more since the day he stepped foot in it and weaved his Golden Boy magic. Located in Bel Air, which we should no longer explain in terms of how expensive that neighborhood is, the mansion herringbone wood floors, vaulted ceilings, and gallery walls lend a casual elegance to the home. The living room features a step-up wet bar and a wine room that shares a large wall aquarium with a formal dining room. 8 bedrooms and 9 bathrooms are within 10,369 square feet of interior space. It even has a separate wing that was designed for entertainment, as it has a theater room, a game room, and an enclosed sunroom. And to make sure that the former professional athlete was at the top of his game, there's also a gym and a dry sauna in a separate wing. Like any mansion, that Bel Air house has an outdoor swimming pool with its own waterfall feature, and behind that swimming pool is a staircase that allows you to access a full-size tennis court that could make Roger Federer himself proud. No wonder this house costs over $18 million ever since the Golden Boy bought it for over $3 million more than 2 decades ago. While we can only drool over that Bel Air mansion that was once owned by Oscar De La Hoya, the Golden Boy now lives in a house that's a bit simpler and modest compared to that Bel Air house, but it's still pretty much so expensive that we probably couldn't afford it. Whenever Oscar De La Hoya is in Pasadena, California, he spends his time in his single-floor apartment unit that measures an impressive 4,150 square feet. It has 3 bedrooms and 4 bathrooms. It comes with a terrace that's about 1,500 square feet in total, as it features plant beds, hardwood, and plentiful room for outdoor lounging. Meanwhile, the interior comes with dark-toned hardwood and natural stone tile flooring, oversized windows, and is finished in beige. The apartment contains a library, a business office, and an eat-in kitchen in a wine cellar. The limestone living room fireplace is perhaps the centerpiece of the home's interior. And how much did Oscar De La Hoya pay for this house? Well, only $2.7 million, which is a price that probably pales in comparison to that Bel Air mansion, but is still quite hefty for a single-floor apartment building in a nice part of Pasadena. Businesses. One of the reasons why Oscar De La Hoya is as rich as he is today is largely due to his business acumen, as he focused more on building up his wealth with his business ventures during the latter portion of his boxing career, and until today, when he is known primarily as a businessman instead of a former boxing champion. Oscar De La Hoya first entered the entrepreneurial world back in 2002 when he founded Golden Boy Promotions, which started as a boxing promotions firm in America. Golden Boy Promotions has since been one of the top promotions in the entire world, as it has gone on to promote such notable boxers like Canelo Alvarez, Devin Alexander, Marco Antonio Barrera, Manny Pacquiao, and Deontay Wilder. In 2018, it was announced that Golden Boy Promotions would also go on to promote mixed martial arts events and combat athletes as Oscar De La Hoya realized that there was plenty of money in the other combat sports as well. In 2005, Oscar De La Hoya announced that his Golden Boy Enterprises would establish Golden Boy Partners, a firm that focused more on the real estate side of business, but was much more concerned about building low-cost communities for Latin Americans. But Oscar De La Hoya never stopped there, because his Golden Boy Enterprises continued to expand and expand as it eventually was able to acquire The Ring, KO Magazine, and World Boxing Magazine from Kappa Publishing Group in 2007. In 2017, Oscar De La Hoya invested $10 million together with Ambina Partners, Atalaya Capital Management, and Brenner International Group in PHP Agency. After investing a huge sum in that company, Oscar De La Hoya went on to say that PHP is dedicated to bringing life insurance and financial products to the Hispanic market. Life insurance is an important product with a story that needs to be told, and I felt PHP is standing in the gap left by traditional financial service companies. I am also pleased to be again joining Brenner International Group and Gabriel Brenner in an investment that has social significance. With all of those different businesses that Oscar De La Hoya spent a lot of time and money on, there's no wondering why this boxing legend is still earning millions and millions of dollars and is widely considered one of the greatest businessman athletes in history of professional sports. A soccer team. In addition to all of the businesses that Oscar De La Hoya spent money on, in the hopes of not only building his wealth, but also helping other people succeed and become just as wealthy, the Golden Boy himself used his net worth to purchase his own professional team in 2008. Oscar De La Hoya, at the tail end of his boxing career at that point, bought a minority stake in the Houston Dynamo soccer team. De La Hoya's financial support for that team was instrumental in erecting a new stadium for the Houston Dynamo in 2012. However, the team hasn't seen much success since De La Hoya joined the franchise. The Dynamo haven't won an MLS Cup since De La Hoya purchased a stake in the team. Houston has missed the playoffs in 5 of the last 6 seasons. Charity. Owing to his Latin American roots, Oscar De La Hoya has always been involved in philanthropic works, not only when they involve Latin Americans, but also in a more general sense, such as those that are concerned with the medical field and the support of children's education. In addition to helping improve Latin American communities with his Golden Boy Partners, Oscar De La Hoya has also helped the medical field thanks to his generous donation of $350,000 to the White Memorial Medical Center via his Cecilia Gonzalez De La Hoya Cancer Center. The reason why the fight against cancer is so close to De La Hoya's heart is that his mother died due to breast cancer back in 1990, before he even won his gold medal in the Olympics. Then, in 2008, he also donated a hefty sum of $3.5 million to the De La Hoya Animo Charter High School, which is located in Los Angeles, California, where a lot of his fellow Latinos live. The high school now serves more than 600 9th through 12th grade students, 100% of whom are minority and 95% economically disadvantaged, as Oscar De La Hoya himself understands how difficult a life for a Latin American minority living in Los Angeles is. And way back in 1995, when Oscar De La Hoya wasn't as rich as he is now, he even established a youth center that catered to the vulnerable minorities of LA so that they could have an outlet and a way to improve athletically instead of staying on the streets where it could be dangerous for them. With that, Oscar De La Hoya not only has golden gloves, but he also has a golden heart that was never too shy to give back to the community. If you want to know how to be as golden as Oscar De La Hoya himself, feel free to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more videos on different celebrities and athletes who spend their millions and billions. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you again in one of our next videos.